viscosity.
Let me ask a simple question. If two bodies of different masses are dropped from a particular height, which one will reach the ground first? Before answering this question, let me ask the great scientist first. Aristotle, a great philosopher and scientist, he told, if two bodies are dropped from a particular height, the heavier one will reach the ground first. Okay. Galileo, after 1800 years in the 16th century, he told, actually he did the experiment in the Pisa Tower, you know the Pisa Tower experiment. If two bodies of different masses are dropped from a particular height, the top of the tower, both reach the ground simultaneously on the ground. It is a very great experiment in physics. Now, Aristotle's idea was disproved by Galileo by a simple Pisa Tower experiment. You can also disprove this idea by dropping two different stones of different masses from a height of a building. If two bodies or two stones are dropped from a particular height, both reach the ground simultaneously. Now, let us discuss the case of a falling of an elephant and a monkey. Consider the free fall of an elephant and a monkey. The mass of elephant suppose 1000 kilogram and the mass of the monkey is 10 kilogram and they reach the ground simultaneously. Why? Or what is the reason for this? Now, let us discuss the answer. For the elephant, the mass is 1000 kilogram, therefore, the force, net force is 10,000 Newton and the acceleration due to gravity is 10 meter per second square. Similarly, in the case of monkey, the mass is 10 kilogram, therefore, the force is 100 Newton. So, acceleration equal to 100 by 10 equal to 10 meter per second square. See, in both these cases, the acceleration is 10 meter per second square. So, both elephant and monkey fall at the same rate of acceleration because they fall under the action of Earth's gravity. Okay. So, the reason, what is the reason for this? The ratio of the force to mass is the same for elephant and monkey and this is equal to acceleration of the bodies. Let us try this experiment in a different way. If you drop a paper from a particular height of the building or top of the building, it will take very long time to reach the ground. Why? The paper will encounter an air resistance. Because of the air resistance, its acceleration is somewhat reduced. If you do the experiment by squeezing the paper, you make the paper as a small ball, then if you drop this, it will fall at the same rate of acceleration due to gravity. So, what is the conclusion here? All the objects under the action of gravity, they fall at the same rate of acceleration. The paper encounter an air resistance. What do you mean by air resistance? It is the force due to the collision of air molecules on the other objects. In the case of paper, the air resistance is more. In the case of paper ball, the air resistance is negligibly small. So, this is the conclusion from this activities. So, for all the objects, if the air resistance is neglected, all the objects are falling at the same rate of acceleration. This is the final conclusion for these activities.